Hello friends, the topic for today's discussion is primary amenorrhea. So what is primary amenorrhea? If a girl, she has reached 13 years of age and has not developed any secondary sexual characters, that is, she has not developed any hair under the armpit, or she has not developed any pubic or axillary hair or breast development, or if a girl, she's 15 years of age and she has not achieved menarche, that is, periods have not come, then we term this as primary amenorrhea. Parents of such children who have not achieved menarche are greatly concerned and they come to us and we guide them through a set of tests and investigations, and I will be briefing. However, this video is not a supplement or it's not a solution for primary amenorrhea. This video is just for education purpose. When one is facing this kind of problem, the most important thing to do is to go and see a fertility consultant or a reproductive endocrinologist who will do a battery of tests and will be able to find out as to what is the reason why this girl is not getting periods. So we will start from very simple things. Like, for example, the first thing is anatomical defects. That is, there could be a problem with the uterus, ovaries, or the vagina that the lady does not have periods. Then second is some kind of hormonal disturbances, like which happens with some genetic disorders where the ovary fails to function and there is ovarian failure in some genetic problems. Most importantly, in Turner syndrome or other problems wherein the ovary stops working and as a result, periods don't come. Other than that, most important these days that we see is obesity, and as a result of that, early onset polycystic ovarian disease. However, in this kind of problem, we usually see secondary sexual characters have been well developed, but the periods are not coming. Or if the periods are coming, they come very, very erratically, like once in a year or once in 6 months, or they come only with medication. However, if one does not have had periods, even for once, by the age of 15 years, it's important to see a fertility or reproductive endocrinologist and do some blood tests by which we will be able to find out what the problem is. And then we can guide these patients further. So most of the times they ask us about the marriage counseling as to if the periods don't come, what we are supposed to do, whether we are supposed to marry her or not. So by doing hormone test, by doing a scan, and if needed an MRI, one will be able to find out reasons why pregnancy is not happening. And if needed, sometimes chromosome studies are done to find out what is the reason. And after that, we can give them a good marriage counseling in terms of if this girl gets married, what are her chances of getting pregnant? And accordingly, the parents can take action, whether, you know, they want to just build her career and then later on see if they want to marry her or not. The problem is that people keep on lying, and they lie that yes, she has periods and there's no problem, and then later on the girl faces a lot of problem. So these type of things should not be done. It should be clear in their minds what is her future prospects. And sometimes we guide them to marry in families where male has a second marriage and he already has children. So this is how parents should manage these kind of problems wherein the girl does not have periods. If they will lie today, then tomorrow they will have problem in the marriage, and that the prospective husband was lied as to she did not have periods before. So these type of things we discourage parents to do. But however, it's not just a physical problem, it's a social problem also. And there will be a set of patients wherein, you know, even if they don't have periods, they get periods with medication, and they can have actually pregnancies even if they don't have periods from childhood. And if a good treatment is done, it is possible sometimes to get them pregnant by using donor eggs or other treatments. However, it's very important to go to the reproductive endocrinologist, get the test done, and then find out what are the chances and then act accordingly. If you have any questions, you can always comment in the comment section. We will be happy to reply. Thank you very much.